And as blood spilled just miles away, Ivanka Trump and Jared Kushner were all smiles as they ceremoniously opened the new U.S. Embassy in Jerusalem. It was a contrast that was slammed by many and highlighted on the cover of the New York Daily News with the headline, Daddy's Little Ghoul. A CNN op-ed summing it up like this, Ivanka's smile was undoubtedly offered to distract from the mayhem and death that any thoughtful person could have anticipated as the embassy opened and Trump abandoned America's claim to honest broker status in the Middle East. And joining me now is the man who wrote that op-ed, CNN contributor and Donald Trump biographer, Michael D'Antonio. And Michael, this is your op-ed, What Ivanka's Smile Can't Hide. You clearly think that she was a poor messenger on behalf of the United States in this case. Why?
Well, I think if this had been a policy that was well thought out and seriously considered, they would have sent someone with serious diplomatic experience. Maybe Nikki Haley should have gone to represent the United States, but instead we get the president's daughter, who was appointed after a lifetime of working for her father in the real estate business, and two pastors whose record is filled with condemnations of the Jewish people. These are pastors who say that only evangelical Christians of their sort are favored by God and everyone else is damned for eternity. So for this and many other reasons, this spectacle yesterday was incredibly painful for much of the world, and all of it was done with no reciprocal exchange on behalf of the Palestinians or the peace process. President Trump just bargained away the status of Jerusalem and got nothing in return.
I have to ask you, Michael, because when I look at your op-ed, and specifically when I look at the New York Daily News cover, where there's this specific focus on Ivanka, yes, she was there, and she had this moment where she is doing the unveiling, right? It does feel like the ribbon cutting of maybe a Trump property or something sort of like that, the ribbon cutting of a new building. But Jared Kushner was there giving the substantive speech with a lot of controversial material in it. Steve Mnuchin was there representing the administration. Why the focus on Ivanka when there's clearly the role of these other prominent members of the administration?
Well, I think it's important to focus on her because her presence was really intended as a smokescreen, as it often is. You know, she is the softer side of the Trump family. She's supposed to lend a gentle air to whatever policy is being implemented, but it's really hard to accept this image making when 55 people are being killed nearby, including many children. And this is a first daughter who has advocated for children and families. It's not the first time that she's presented herself as the softer side of the president, and it rarely works, and it seems intensely hypocritical.